Hello everyone, welcome to this week's Craft Mix video. It's already number 3 and today you're watching my desk from a different angle than normally in my Craft Mix videos, because that is, this happened. Yeah, cannot be repaired anymore, it was just a cheap one, so I have to go buy a new one. So that's why I need to use my camera stand that's above my desk. So yeah, that's why. And in this video I have one beautiful Christmas card to show you. I did a lot of hauling together with my friend Adeshda, and also alone. My order from AliExpress came in, and that's mostly Cass Crafts. And in the stores I went for Valentine papers, because I am joining a Valentine swap, as I already told you in my last Craft Mix video. But what I forgot to tell you is that I as well am joining a different collaboration this year, and I will have to look it up how it's called exactly. And that's the Stash Dive collab for 2022 with Poet Spice. I think most of you all know them. And each third Friday of the month you have to present, or you have to make and show a project with products that are 6 months or older. So your project must be all made with craft supplies that are 6 months or older. And yeah, I have things in my craft room that are, well, 10 years or older, so that will not be a problem. And that's why I joined this challenge, to to dig out your old craft supplies and use them and not let them sit on your shelf. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And yeah, they will post it, but it's in American time, on 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And if I am correct, it's at 4 o'clock in the afternoon here in the Netherlands. So yeah, that's another challenge that I'm going to do. And I don't know if I told you, but I am also in a challenge with my friend Nadezhda. We challenge each other each month the upcoming year, and the first challenge of January will be make a shaker memory decks. The card that I'm going to show to you today is as well from Nadezhda. She was here last Friday, we went shopping, and yeah, we had a great time. And this is the card that she made, beautiful craft card that I like so much, and she put a big tag on top, a beautiful wood piece. She gifted me some of these as well. I asked her where she buys them. Well, she found them a whole lot in a thrift store. So yeah, that's really nice find. How do you say that? So yeah, I really like it. It's beautiful. And in our swap, she gifted some to me so I can use them for next year. And she just added a cute image on top. She added some fake snow, some beautiful lace that she loves so much. Cute fabric here, and a small bow. So yeah, and on the inside is her, well, it's her message to me from her and her husband and son. So yeah, thank you Nadezhda for the beautiful card. It will go up in my living room. So yeah, that's the only happy mail that came in this week. Yeah. Then we go start with our order from AliExpress. The first thing is not from KS Craft, and I think you will all recognize it. That's this one. It's an eraser for glue. I am crafting for over 12 years now, I think, and I have never owned this thing. So I thought it was time to do so, and I bought it on AliExpress because, yeah, it's really cheap there. If you want any links to the products, you can ask me in the comment section, and I will send them to you. So yeah, that's one. And then here is my order from KS Crafts. The first thing, I still have it in the packaging, is some of the dies I use, so I can show a little bit of an example. This is the extra they put in, so really sweet. And it said it's a boy, so yeah, it's for a newborn card. I really like this. I am for sure going to use it. And then we go to the die sets. First die sets I'm going to show you, I did not try out yet, so I will do that and then show it to you. But it's Christmas related, and if I'm honest, I'm done with my Christmas crafting. Maybe I will put this together, but for the rest I'm done. I have cleaned out my room with my Christmas craft supplies, and I am pulling out all my Valentine stuff. So yeah, and I hope you can see it here. I will put it in my hands. And yeah, you will all recognize it. It's nothing new. It's the gingerbread house die from KS Crafts. And you can make it a shaker. That's with this piece. And you have a lot of layering pieces like here, like the gumdrops. And a heart and the frosting to go over the door. So yeah, I think this will make a beautiful gingerbread house. And I must say, I didn't pay attention to the size, which is quite a big size. So on a card front, yeah, you have an instant card, I think. You don't need much more. So yeah, that's this one. I really wanted this for quite some time. The next one is a Valentine one that I'm for sure going to use on my next project. And yeah, you will all see it. I have already seen it in different videos from the designers from KS Craft. But it's the heart gumball machine. So, so adorable. Look, the heart with the arrow. I really like this. So yeah, can't wait to play with this one. The other one, when you see it, yeah, it doesn't say much. I really needed to think when it came in what this guy was. And then I looked at my order and then I thought, oh yeah, that's for this. Because look, you get this. And if you don't have this, you probably think, where is this die for? But it's the mug die. This die makes a mug. So you cut out this 6 times, put it on the base, and these are all the pieces for the handle. And you have layering pieces for everything. So yeah, I can't wait to try this out, and this can be used all year for gift giving. So really happy with this one. The other one is another one. I think it's an older one, but I really like it, and especially for birthdays. But you can also use them on any holiday or occasion, because yeah, if you add things, you can make it how you want. And this circus tent die. Really, really cute. I love it. You can make it a shaker as well. It has stitching. It has the word fun. You have here some decoration pieces. I really, really love this. It's so beautiful. And yeah, really happy with this one. Then the last two I'm going to show you are dies that I already used, because I could not wait to play with them. And again, you have seen this in different videos, but I'm going to show you my take on it. And that's the heart donut die. I have the small size. I did not buy the big one. And this size is perfect for me. So I'm so happy I did not choose the big size. And I did play with this. I made some different kind of cookies. And I will first show you the ones I did with this die set. Look, I made 5 of each, so they're all the same. Look how cute. I used everything on the in the die set. So I used the sprinkles and the sentiment that is in the die set. What I did for the base is I used brown cardstock. I bought several brown cardstocks at the local craft store when I was there last week. But what I did is I hope you can see it. You can see it in the back better. I did emboss the hearts when I cut them out with an embossing folder on this one. And this one for some extra texture. And I thought it looked a little bit more like a cookie. And yeah, preferable you need to use a grid embossing folder. But I do not have that, so I could not use that. But is it on this one? No. On the other ones I'm going to show you, I used my this one, my scoreboard, the small one that I have, to add texture to the base of the cookie. So yeah, and I will show that to you as well. And there are these ones. Quite hard to see on camera, but it is already a bezel cardstock, so it has some texture. But with my embossing tool that I just showed you, I made the lines like a grid, and then it gets some extra texture. So I etched everything with the vintage photo distress oxide to, yeah, I think it looks a little bit more like a baked cookie then. And on this one, I added this piece with some clay pieces or shaker pieces, also from KS Craft. And with my gold marker, I etched the frosting. I thought it looked cute. So with the die set I just showed you, I made till now these two styles of cookies. I really like them, really cute for Valentine's project, but as well for a birthday or yeah, whatever. So that's this one, and the last embossing die, or die embossing die, the last die I bought at KS Craft is this one. Also not new, but yeah, I just love it. And when I saw the entry that I received in the pink shaker swap from Wendy, my sweet creative life, she made some of these hearts for us. And I thought, yes, I need those. So I bought them. And you can make heart embellishments with them, but I wanted to make cookies with them because, yeah, I was in the cookie mode. And there are these. I made several. So, yeah, I'm going to lay them out. I use different kind of papers for my stash. Digital papers, normal paper. But you get the two sizes in one pack. So you don't need to order both. This comes together. And look how cute it is. So yeah, it's really beautiful with the white frosting if you make it a red or a green cookie for Christmas. But I thought it was cute for Valentine's Day. And yeah, I think it looks like a cookie, but it's as well just a normal heart embellishment, of course. I could not resist to enter or to put the pearls in the center of these hearts. Yeah, really versatile die, and I'm happy I bought this. And when I was in the cookie mode, I thought about the cookies I received in my 12 days of Christmas swap from my friend Nadezhda. And one of them was this. And I really liked the scalloped cookie. She made it a shaker. I did not do that. And I made it in a smaller size. But I wanted to replicate this kind of cookie. So I made these ones. And I used the sentiment die from my stash. I don't know where it's from. And this is how they came out. So small ones. I again etched the frosting with the gold marker that I have, and I used glitter cardstock for it. And for some topping, or how do you call that, sprinkles, I used my Nouveau drops on here. So yeah, I made five of those. Oh, and what I did do at this one is I used the dot embossing folder from my stash for the base piece. So yeah, there's a little bit more texture. So yeah, that were the cookies that I made, and that's honestly the only thing till now I can show you what I made this week. I didn't make a lot. I only made two ornaments for Christmas to give out, but one is not ready yet, so I'm going to show that probably next week, because with Christmas I'm going to give them out. So yeah, you have to stay tuned for that. And this was all the dies and the stuff from AliExpress. As I told you in the beginning of the video, I went to two scrapbook stores. The first one is the Scrap Heap. That's in a city nearby. And I bought a few items there. The first things are dies, and that were second-hand dies that they sold. And I could not resist them. I thought these were so beautiful. So I cannot tell you where they're from. They come without packaging. I was really happy she gifted the magnetic sheets with me, because these are the ones that I use, the small ones and the big ones. So yeah, and I really love this oval with this piece, and I can use this for layering on this one. Really versatile. But I also really loved this layering set. Isn't this cute? It has cute layers, small circles on the inside if you want, but I really liked the leaves in the corners of it. And you have the layering pieces for the leaves, and even they are two layers, so that will look very cute when I'm going to cut them out. So yeah, really beautiful. And then I found this small film strip die. I have the big one from Tim Holtz. Because it is so big, I hardly use it. I think that's more sized for a scrapbook layout and not for a smaller project. But then I saw this one, and I don't know from which brand it is. I think probably Marianne Design. But this is so small, and yeah, I really love this one. And the other one was this bow. Look at the detailing in the die. It's so cute. I didn't cut it out yet, but can't wait to play with this as well. It's so beautiful. So yeah, really happy to have found those. What I also found there was a big spool of ribbon for just €1 in the sale. And yeah, it still has a lot on it. And it's a beautiful pink mesh trim that is really cute to use for layering. So yeah. Also on clearance for €1.50, these wooden spools. I didn't have any of those, so yeah, really happy. You can use them to give out ribbon in swaps or to make it as a dangle. Yeah, I've seen several things with those. What they also had was this in the sale for €1. Of course, it's for summer crafting. I love these, so adorable. I do think I'm going to glue a bail to it, a clear bail, so I can make it a dangle. Really beautiful colors. She also had my favorite kind of stickles that I ran out of, the diamond stickles. So I'm going to put it right in this place. Then she also had on clearance, or well, second hand I think, but a lot of the Dutch Doobadoo folders. This one I really like for quite some time. This is a really old one. I did not buy it till now, but I have to make cards for 2 birthdays for small boys, and I thought this would be really cute to use as the base for the card. And then I can use this die. They cannot read, so they cannot read Dutch, but they also cannot read English, so it doesn't matter, it is in English. I'm going to use this die, I think, in the middle, if that fits. And then embellish it a little bit more. So yeah, that's why I bought this die. I bought some new acetate sheets. I didn't have this brand till now, so I'm going to try this out. The other ones that I have, I'm not so happy with it. And this one, the examples in the store looked really good, so let's see. And again in the clearance, I found this one, and it's an old Craft and New paper pad. It's 6x6 inch for just €1. Easter greetings. You get 36 sheets, 3 sheets per design, and it's a vintage style paper. It's a little bit Beatrix Potter like, and I really love that. So yeah, look, they are single sided, but aren't these beautiful patterns? I hope you can see it. I am filming this at night with my lights on because I have to work late almost each day this week, because it's really busy before our holidays vacation. We close between Christmas and New Year. So yeah, look, so sweet. I love yellows, and this is one of my favorite pages. This one as well. This one, beautiful pink one with flowers. Another pink one, beautiful stripes, love these colors. Blue one with a cute little girl, and a plain blue one with a little bit of distressing. It's so light, my camera really doesn't pick all the colors good, but yeah, it's just, you can see it here, it's all pastel-y. So yeah, for Easter crafts. Not ready to do that, but I will keep it for that. And then the next day, Nadezhda came to my house because we needed to exchange something, and we went to the hobbyboerderij. Yeah, to the hobbyboerderij. And oh, I'm sorry, I did forget to show you some Valentine papers that I bought at the scrap heap also. These are large sheets. They're not really for a Valentine collection, but I can use this. And the crepe paper fans will probably recognize this. I bought several sheets of this from the Gather collection. And yeah, because of this heart print, it's a really soft orangey pink with cute striped hearts. So I thought it would be nice to use in Valentine's crafts. And from the Heart Day collection from Crate Paper, I found the pages with these lips. So I bought a few of those. This is the one from Gather. I bought several of them because I think I'm going to use them for my Valentine swap. And I need to make 4, so yeah. And also from Crepe Paper, I see, was this one. It's the Hard Day. And it doesn't have a hard print, but I love the big polka dots in the pink. So yeah, in the hot pink. I bought also several of those. And for the rest, I bought some cardstock there. It's all Basel, I think. Yes, this is a glittery one from Basel in pink. Another one. It's a little bit darker. And yeah, they are just the same. So yeah, also Valentine's crafting, of course. Now I'm going to show you what I bought at the hobbyboerderij. I was really, I didn't buy a lot. What I did buy was this gorgeous paper pad from Intai. And it's the Love Letters 6x6 scrapbooking paper pads. And this is a Valentine collection for the shabby vintage lovers. And you know, I like both. I like shabby vintage. I like cutesy. I just like everything. But this is really beautiful. And I am thinking of making a card from this collection for my husband. Because he really likes the vintage busy style as well. If I make my projects and show them to him, he always likes the busy vintage projects the most. So yeah. And now I think it repeats. Double-sided, really sturdy cardstock. I worked with the Mintai papers before and yeah, it's just gorgeous. So yeah, that's this one. And they didn't have the ephemera, but they did have the cardboard stickers to go with it. So yeah, that's this. And then the last things I bought at Noor en Zo. I went there on my own this week, also on the hunt for Valentine. The first thing I found was this small paper pad from Echo Park. I asked if they still had the big one. This is a collection from last year. I loved it. But last year I worked with a collection from Simple Stories, vintage. The vintage Valentine. And yeah, I just liked it. And you know, this was just one that they had left over from last year. So yeah, that's the Echo Park Hello Valentine. Yeah, most of the people probably know this paper. I have seen a lot of people make projects with this last year. So yeah. And the quality of the Echo Park paper is really good. It's such sturdy paper. Look how cute these. Yeah, it's still a little bit. Yeah. Black and white stripe. Beautiful heart pattern with leaves. Black and white check. I love these jars with the bunches of flowers in them. Here again, beautiful cut aparts. This one I love as well. I like black with pink. Small heart print. And then I think it repeats. Yes, it does. So yeah, I love this 24 double-sided paper. That's this one. And then I found this one. It's a Dutch Doobadoo crafty paper slimline. Very sweet. So especially sized for slimline cards, but for embellishments, etc. You can use it as well, of course. So let's see what's on the inside. We have some cute papers. It has one black cardstock as the back piece, I think. And here are the papers. And I do believe it is... No, it's double-sided. This one is so cute with the strawberries on the check background. And look, a red and white polka dot. You get two of those. Then we have a pink with small hearts. And on the back is this pattern. Again, you get two of those. Then we have a red with white hearts and a green polka dot. Two of those. A beautiful stripe pattern with the pink check. And let us first look at the papers. You get a different strawberry pattern. And yeah, the background paper is also a little bit pink. It's hard to see, but with a green check. And the other one is green polka dots with this. So yeah. And you get 2 sheets of these cute strawberry die cuts. I really like this one who winks. So adorable. Oh, and I see they're all different. None of them is the same. So yeah, really cute to use on a card or on an embellishment. So yeah, you will see me use those in the Valentine projects as well. And the next one I'm going to show you is this set. This is not really a Valentine set. But I think it's so cute, and I do think you can use it for this. It's more like a sweet theme. But it's from Bella Lulu. It's a Dutch brand from Lorenzo. It's called The Little Chef. It is A4, European A4 size paper, and it includes 22 pages. And let's see what we have. We have a few die cuts. Well, fussy cut pages, so you have to fussy cut them out. Really cute look. You get the little chef. They're all gnomies, so adorable. It's a little bit doodlebug like, but a little bit more shabby, on the shabby side. You get these, the numbers with candles on it. So yeah, I really like this. Those were so cute. And then I will show you the papers quickly, because I see we're already at 26 minutes. This one is really versatile for any occasion. Here we have a grid with the letters. And this, again, really beautiful. These are also really nice to use in journals, as you see, because you get some of the writing papers. Beautiful sprinkles and the pink polka dots. Different kind of sprinkles. And of course, the hearts with the black polka dots. And the pages do not repeat. You have one page of the pattern paper, so yeah. I wish you got 2 of them at least, because now you will need to choose which pattern you are going to use of the cute papers. So yeah, here it has sprinkles and some frosting or dripping chocolate. So yeah, that's the last one. That were the papers from that Little Chief paper pad from Bella Lulu. And then I think I am done to show you what I have for this week. I am quickly looking at my craft room. Yeah, I've showed you everything. So yeah, I hope you will be back for my next week's craft mix video. I am creating for Valentine and for birthdays right now. So if I have something to show you, I will in a separate video. If it's a large project. Well, I'm sorry for this. My camera fell off because now this is not a great day. This piece came off of my above camera that I'm using above my desk. So now I really have a problem. I really need to go buy new ones. So yeah, this was a rough ending to my video. I hope you didn't get scared by this. And I hope you will be back for my next one next week. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.